morning, brothers and sisters. It is a good thing to be worshiping the Lord this morning. We welcome you and we pray that this service will be a blessing to you. We begin our service this morning with the hymn number 52 in the VIP, Let Earth and Heaven Agree. Continue as we follow. Please make the appropriate responses with the call to worship. When you withdraw their breath, they die and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created and renew the face of the earth. God sent the Holy Spirit to the disciples with a sound from heaven and in tongues of flame. Send us out in the power of the same Spirit to witness to your truth and to draw all peoples to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us worship God in spirit and in truth. Amen. Let us go to God in prayer, our prayer of adoration. O Lord God Almighty, Father of all creation, Redeemer of mankind, we adore you. As we come to you, O God, we recognize that you are worthy to be praised. We praise and bless your holy name for all your goodness and loving kindness to humanity. We bless you for our preservation and for your unceasing generosity to us throughout our lives. But above all, we bless you for your gift of the Holy Spirit, which was promised to all believers and which fills us with joy and boldness to preach the everlasting gospel and enables us to witness to your truth and draw all people to you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our prayers of confession. Sisters and brothers, in silence, let us confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. God, our Lord and Creator, this morning, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with all our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. But you have kept faith with us. Have mercy on us. Strip us of all that is unchristian and help us to live up to our calling. Merciful God, we confess to you now that we have sinned. We confess the sins that no one knows and the sins that everyone knows. We confess the sins that are a burden to us and the sins that do not bother us because we have grown used to them. We confess our sins as a church. We have not loved one another as Christ loved us. We have not forgiven one another as we have been forgiven. We have not given ourselves in love and service for the world as Christ gave himself for us. Father, forgive us. Send the Holy Spirit to us, that he may give us power to live as by your mercy you have called us to live. O Lord, our God, you know us better than we know ourselves. As we come before you now, believers and doubters alike, we all share a deep need, for we are all lost without your grace. Search us, O God, and know our hearts. Test us and know our troubled thoughts. Give us true repentance. Forgive us all our wrongs. Transform us by your Spirit to live for you each day, to learn to serve each other, and through the grace of Jesus Christ our Lord, to come at last to heaven. And cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Amen. The assurance of pardon. Who is a pardoning God like you? Who else has grace so rich and so free? Almighty God, we come to your fountain of pardon, believing that you do not keep a record of our wrongs, and that having confessed our sins, you will faithfully forgive us and purge us from all unrighteousness. Amen. People of God, it is done. Your sins are forgiven. Our prayer of thanksgiving. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. Father, we give you thanks and praise for your goodness and love. Great and wonderful are your works. Just and true are all your ways. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, we have been accepted and made your children by water and the Spirit. So through your Son, we now offer ourselves again to you to be a living sacrifice to your praise and glory. For the outpouring of your Spirit on the church, for the commissioning of the church to make disciples, for the spreading of your kingdom throughout the world, we give you thanks and praise. Together, accept these prayers and praises through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation, world without end. Amen. We continue as we sing the hymn, Captain of Israel's Host and Guide. Hymn number 327.
God's a Lord.
our collect for today, we pray together. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of the church is governed and sanctified, hear our prayer which we offer for all your faithful people, that in their vocation and ministry, they may serve you in holiness and truth to the glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our gospel reading comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 13, verses 24 to 30 and 36 to 43. Glory be to you, O God. He put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seeds in his field. But while everybody was asleep, an enemy came and sowed seeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. And the slaves of the household came and said to him, "Master, did you not sow good seed in the field? Where then did these seeds come from?" He answered, "An enemy has done this." The slave said to him, "Then do you want us to go and gather them?" But he replied, "No, for in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest. And at harvest time, I will tell the reapers, 'Collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn.'" Verse 36, "Then he left the crowds and went to the house. And his disciples approached him, saying, 'Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field.' He answered, 'The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one. And the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with the fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and evildoers. And they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let anyone with ears listen." My brothers and sisters, this is the gospel of Christ.
Thank you, Brother Prosper. We prepare ourselves to hear God's word this morning. And before we do that, we will do a hymn of preparation, "Who is on the Lord's Side?"
Thank you.
on the Lord's side. Our theme for this morning's message is Live Right in a World of Counterfeits. I now have the honor to call on Reverend Seth Ampadu, who will bring us the message this morning.
My brothers and sisters, this morning we give thanks and praise to God for the fact that by His grace, His mercies, He has kept all of us. We thank Him for the grace, the fact that we are on the land of the living. It is just by the grace of God. It is not good that we have done that we deserve to be alive. Just by the grace of God. So we give thanks and praise to God. And let me thank Sister May Kodra for conducting the service to this point. Let us bow our heads as we go to God in prayer. O God of grace, God of mercies, God of love, God of peace, this blessed day, Lord, we come before you. We give you thanks and praise for your goodness, your mercy is upon our lives. Father, we thank you for our lives. We thank you by the grace of your Son, Jesus Christ, we are on the land of the living. It is not our own making, but it is just by the grace. So this morning, we thank you for all our church members, those who are in the church, and those who could not make it, and they are worshiping from home. And all our visitors, our friends, our loved ones, we thank you for their lives. Today, Lord, we lift our worship, God, in your hands. We pray especially as your word is coming to us. The Bible says your word do not come in vain. It has to accomplish its purpose. So, Lord, even as your word is coming, open our hearts, our minds, oh God, that your word will find root in our heart. Precious Jesus. Those who are suffering, those who are in pain, those who are in trouble, we pray that, Lord, let the power in your word talk to them. So let the words of my mouth, the meditation of our heart, be pleasing and acceptable unto you, God. You are the source of wisdom and knowledge, O God. So, Lord, I pray, as I stand before your people to deliver your message to your people, O God, I pray for your wisdom, knowledge, to be able, O God, to expound the meaning of your word to your people. So, Lord, have your own way. Teach us, O God, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, I'm reading from Matthew chapter 13, verses 24 to 30. Matthew 13, 34 to 30. And that is our test for meditation. And it reads, He put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seed in his field. But while everybody was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. Now, verse 26 says, So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. 27, And the slaves of the householder came and said to him, Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then these weeds come from? Verse 28, the master answered, An enemy has done this. And I want you to take note of that. The slave said to him, Then do you want us to go and gather them? But he replied, No, for in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat along with them. And verse 30 says, Let both of them grow together until the harvest. And at the harvest time, I will tell you the reapers, collect the weeds first and burn them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn. My brothers and sisters, our theme, live right in the world of counterfeits. Live right in the world of counterfeits. In other words, we are called to be real in the world of fake people and fake things. My brothers and sisters, it is time for us to do our very best to pull out the weeds or the counterfeits in our society and even in our own lives. There is no doubt that today we live in a world where good and evil coexist. And there is nothing we can do about that. Is how the world is. That is how our world is going. Good and bad exist together. Even in our own lives, there is good side and at the same time bad side. Each of us is a mix of bad, capable of good and evil. We sometimes love and hate. We build up and at the same time we tear down. Today our world is saturated by some people who are false. We have false teachers and good teachers, false leaders and good leaders. We have false media men and women who are always peddling false news in our society. At the same time, we have some good media men and women who bring out good news to the public to build our society. We have false politicians and good politicians. We have fake or counterfeit religious leaders. At the same time, we have good religious leaders. We have some religious leaders who are good. We have false medical practitioners. And at the same time, we have bad ones. Some people today are so gullible that they almost believe everything they read on the social media space. We do not verify authenticity or the source of the news, but conveniently share such news and secret them. Such news spreads like a wildfire. And by the time you take corrective measures, the damage is done. My brothers and sisters, we are literally surrounded by fake stuff. Sometimes the food we consume daily may not all be genuine. The food supplements we use, some are contaminated. And it is on our shelves and counters, health products that we use, the medicine and the rest that we use, that we consume, could be fake. Beverages are often adulterated, especially alcohol-related products. My brothers and sisters, then again, the currency we use for our transactions could be fake. And we know too well how fake currencies can paralyze economies around the world. Today, we hear about fake websites and scams that trap people into investing and fraudulent schemes that promise huge returns. Today, my brothers and sisters, we can be proud of having many friends. The question is, how many of these friends are really genuine? Or are they only fair weather friends? How many will stand by you in your moment of need? Even among our relatives, we will have few who are never happy to see us succeed or prosper in life. In marriages, sometimes couples exchange their vows to keep true and loyal to their spouse and pledge to remain as husband and wife until death do them apart. The question is, how many really keep this pledge? Sometimes when poverty comes through the door, love flies out through the window. During rough times, not many partners are willing to stay together. My brothers and sisters, in short, there will always be good and evil coexisting in every society. It is our collective duty as individual Christians to be authentic and uphold truth living, to refute the few counterfeits so they will not destroy our society. So in our gospel reading for today, Jesus used the parable of the wheat and the weeds to teach us about the need for us to be real in the world of counterfeit. The need to be patient and also not to judge other people wrongly. My brothers and sisters, in the parable before us, Jesus used an agricultural illustration to explain the truth about the kingdom of God and its principles. It was a story that made sense to his listeners because Israel at the time was an agricultural society. In the text, we are told a man has taken considerable time and effort to sow his field with good seed, with the full expectation of producing a fine and bountiful harvest grain. We are told, in the night, however, his enemy comes and deliberately oversows his wheat field with deadly weeds. So if you look at verse 25, it says, but while everybody was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. My brothers and sisters, that is the world that we find ourselves. There will always be good and bad. And therefore, we need to be real. We need to be authentic in order to refute the bad among us. So in the text, the landowner's servant, they ask this question. Should we go and put out the weeds among the wheat? But listen to the landowner. The landowner said, no, don't do that. So what is this weeds or the tares that the devil sow among the good seed? The word weeds or tear is a particular type of weed that looks just like wheat as it is growing up together. You can hardly tell the difference between the wheat and the tares or the weeds. It looks like wheat. It appears like wheat, but it is not wheat. It is fake wheat or counterfeit wheat. They look alike, but they are different. So the servants, they were so suspicious. They were alarmed when they saw the weeds among the good seeds. When they saw these fake weeds, they asked the master, according to verse 27, they asked, Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from? That was the question that they asked. And for me, this is a very important question. You could see that the landowner saw a good seed. The slaves were aware that the master saw a good seed. They know the master did sow a good seed on the field. That is why they are so surprised when they discover the weeds. The weeds have shattered their illusion. This wasn't what we planted on the field. My brothers and sisters, as you know, weeds are plants that grow unwantedly. They are often prolific and persistent. Weeds compete with plants for water, light, nutrient, and space. Weeds resemble plants, but they do not bear fruit. Some weeds are parasites, either partially or totally, or plants. Weeds interfere with agricultural operations, increase labor cost, and reduce crop yields. The servant asks again, where then did these weeds or counterfeit wheat come from? So if you look at verse 28, Jesus provided answer for them. Jesus said, an enemy has done this. An enemy has done this. So today and this morning, what lesson can we learn from this parable? The first lesson I want to draw to your attention is that Satan can plant immoral seeds in people's hearts. Let me repeat that. Satan can plant immoral seeds in people's hearts. You see, sometimes you may not be aware. Just like the slaves in the parable, whilst they were sleeping at night, the enemy sow evil seed. So sometimes we may not know. Gradually, we could recognize that the bad seed has been sown in our heart. The enemy isn't noticeable. When he tempts people, he plants his tares or weeds in people's hearts. And it is not until later that the harmful consequences become obvious. My brothers and sisters, he is busy sowing seeds of hate and discord. Seeds of unfaithfulness in marriages, in relationships, and discontentment in people's hearts. He is so busy sowing seeds of pride, boastfulness, backbiting, disobedience, deceit, jealousy, envy, and strife in our hearts. So in James chapter 3:16, it says, for where there is envy and selfishness, ambition, there will also be disorder and wickedness of every kind. So today, if we look at our society, the shootings and the killing going on, all because we have allowed Satan to sow the seed of pride, impatience in our hearts. My brothers and sisters, the point is that sometimes we allow ourselves for the devil to use us to sow seeds in people's hearts. The question I want to ask is, why do we sow these seeds among our brothers and sisters in the society? Because we want to destroy our society. And because of that, we allow ourselves for Satan to sow seeds of discord and hatred in our heart. Do we take time as people to look into our heart and see what is there? Today we are called by God to uplift and encourage our fellow men and women. But instead, we find ways to tear them down. We say we love God, but at the same time, we have hatred in our heart for our brothers and sisters. So 1 John chapter 4, verse 20 says, if a man says or a woman says, I love God, and hate his or her brother or sister, he or she is a liar. So the world in which we live is in a mess, all because immoral seeds sown by the devil have taken over the field of our heart. And that is why we see what we are seeing in our society today. Within this short period, look at the number of people that have been killed. Some people have never figured out their troubles, began as tiny seeds sown by spiritual enemy while they were sleeping. Do not allow yourself for the devil to sow bad seed in your life. We need to be vigilant. We need to be spiritually awakening. The devil is in the business of killing, stealing, and destroying, according to John chapter 10, verse 10. And Satan does this in part by planting and producing lookalikes or counterfeit that strive to hinder the work of God. My brothers and sisters, God is responsible for good seed. The good seed is indeed the word of God. Our words are seeds. Just as Christ has a good gospel, Satan also has bad gospel too. And therefore, we need to speak life into ourselves and others, my brothers and sisters. Satan is using fake things to destroy our lives. Let us remember today that Satan can plant immoral seeds in our hearts, and therefore we need to be vigilant. The second thing that we can learn from this parable is that learn to be patient. We need to be patient in everything that we do. You see, patience is the key to fish out or fight out the negativity in our lives. Patience is the key to fight fake and counterfeit in our society. So again, if you look at the parable carefully, the slaves ask the question, do you want us to go and gather the weeds right now? So you could see that the slaves, they were impatient. They wanted to go and uproot the bad ways. But listen to what the master said, verse 29. But the master replied, no, for in gathering the weeds, you will uproot the weeds along with them. So in other words, the master was asking them to wait, not to rush. And the point is, if the servant had rampaged through the field tearing up the good weeds along with the tares or the weeds, what kind of mess would have been created about the good seed? So my brothers and sisters, it takes patience to know the fake people in your life. Patience demands that we resist the urge to act on our impulses. It invites us to rest, even if just for a moment, and imagine new possibilities. Our impulses demand that we act now. They lead us down the path of violence. It is the path we take when we have chosen not to wait for God. So the master says, for in gathering the weeds, you will uproot the wheat along with them. And therefore, take time. You see, when you take violence as a way of resolving your issue or approaching things, you destroy things, rather. You become a failure. And therefore, those who think they can use violence in the society, they are rather destroying themselves. Violence is deceptive. It blinds us to the damage inflicted upon ourselves in the process of destroying others. My brothers and sisters, we must learn to think. We must learn to act in the right way. We must learn to recognize when and where we should act. Otherwise, we will always make mistakes in life. So I want to encourage someone today. Take your time. Today, God is asking us to prepare. In some cases, to wait. And to not to over-anxious to pull out weeds, lest we will harm the right people. Be patient in everything that you do. At your workplace, be patient. In your marriage, be patient. In your relationship, God expects you to be patient. My brothers and sisters, we need to treat others with kindness. So let us remember today that patience is the key to fish out negativity in our lives. Patience is the key to fight fake and counterfeit people in a society. And finally, judgment is reserved for God alone. Judgment is reserved for God alone. So if you look at verse 30, it says, let both of them grow together until the harvest, and at harvest time, I will tell the reapers, collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn. Only God can judge. We human beings are not to judge. It is God's responsibility for making the final judgment. We do not have to judge anyone. So if people get into heated arguments over who is going to heaven and hell, sometimes I laugh. Who are you to determine that this person is going to heaven or hell? It is only God. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, we judge our brothers and sisters from Muslim community. This person is a Buddhist. This person is a Jew, Catholic, Baptist, Methodist, Mormons, Adventists, and the rest. We argue about this thing. But Jesus is telling us that. Let us wait. In the final, it is God who is going to judge us. God knows the heart. And God makes the call based on God's reading of the heart. You and I can see into another person's heart. We are not in the position to judge anyone. So my brothers and sisters, we are not permitted to condemn our neighbors. This does not mean that when we see someone doing wrong, we should approve or endorse. God expects no less of us than to willingness to love our neighbor despite all his sinfulness and to pray for his redemption. Loving our neighbor brings us closer to God. When we are attentive to our neighbor, we attest that God's salvation also applies to him. So my brothers and sisters, let us stop competing as we were weeds and wheat, and to get along with each other in the society. We cannot judge which hearts are true and which hearts are false. It is not my role, it is not your duty to figure out who are the tares or the weeds and who are the wheat. Let God do that. As I conclude, to our young people in the country, let us remember that weeds or counterfeits in our lives hinders our spiritual growth. Weeds or counterfeits can damage your entire lives. With wrong people and wrong thoughts, this can damage your soul. And therefore, let us resist the attitude of violence in our society. It is not going to help you. Thoughts are much like these weeds. Some thoughts get planted in our minds that are not supposed to be there. They are not supposed to be there because they are in direct conflict with God's word. These thoughts may be thoughts of temptation to do wrong, thoughts of lust, of insecurity, fear, worry, malice, doubt, envy, jealousy, sexual immorality, pride, negative self-talk of any kind. We need to avoid all these things. If these thoughts are not removed from your minds, regardless of how small or seemingly insignificant, they could multiply and grow stronger and crowd out the good and godly thoughts in your mind. And at the end of it all, it will destroy you. So I want to appeal to our young people. We love you. We know some of you are doing great things. You are doing a lot of exploits in our nation, and we appreciate the few who have gone astray. We are appealing to you. The guns and the knives cannot solve the problem. If you have any issue, that is why the church opened its doors. So many churches around. So if you have any issue, why don't you go and report to the police or go to court to solve your problem? Let us remember that the violence cannot solve the problem that we are facing as society. Let us remember that God sees everything. He judges everything. So whatever problem that you have, God is in charge. Do not take the vengeance in your own hand. Do not judge. So this morning, as I conclude, are you a seed or a weed? Are you a seed or weed? It is my prayer that we will always do the right thing. We need to be authentic. We need to remove all the face masks on our faces and be authentic. When you are under pressure, what does your mask look like? What types of masks you wear through the day? What type of seed are you? Are you a wheat or tare? Are you a good seed or bad seed? Remember, we are called to be real in the world of counterfeit. The name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us bow heads as we go to God in prayer. Just spend a moment. Just reflect and ponder upon these words. Are you wheat or tares or wheat? The word of God has come to you. What is the condition of your heart? If Jesus were to inspect your heart, will he find love? Would he find peace? Would he find gentleness in your heart? Or Jesus will find weeds, the tears in your heart. Just allow the Holy Spirit to remove all the weeds in your heart so that the good seed that God planted in your heart, it will not compete with these weeds. And so, Lord, we want to thank you for your word. We pray at this time, bringing before you the young people in our nation. We want to thank you for their lives. We thank you for how far you are using some of them to build our nation. We appreciate the kind of work that some of them are doing to promote and project the nation. But yes, the Lord, some of them would have gone astray. They would have allowed themselves for the devil to sow weeds in their heart. And therefore they sought to violence and things that are not pleasing to your holy name. We lift such young people in your hands. We pray that, Lord, any bad seed that have been sown, O God, in their heart by the power and the blood of Jesus, O God, we pray that you uproot all those false weeds, O God, in their heart and set these young people free, O God, so that the violence and the evil going on, it will stop. Bless our country. Our leaders are in your hands. Continue to grant wisdom, knowledge, O God, even as they lead us. Let your words, O God, find grounds, O God, in our heart, that, Lord, we will always be authentic and real in this fake society. May your name be glorified through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen and amen.
Amen. Thank you, Reverend Ampadu, for this thought-provoking message. And I pray that as we go throughout this week, that we'll remember what we have heard. Are we weeds or are we seeds? Are we sowing good seeds or are we sowing bad seeds? We give God thanks for this message this morning. We will now go into our intercessory prayers and please make the appropriate responses. O God, our healer, today we humbly ask you to show your compassion for the whole human family that is in turmoil and burdened with illness and with fear, especially those in our families and in our society. Grant your healing grace upon them and give them peace. Hear our cry, O God, listen to our prayer. Gracious Lord, come to our aid as the coronavirus is still spreading globally. We humbly ask you to heal all those who are sick, support and protect their families and friends from being infected. Continue, O Lord, to protect our country, St. Lucia, from all harm and danger, especially in this hurricane season. Hear our cry, O God. Grant us your spirit of love and self-discipline so that we may come together working to control and eliminate the coronavirus. Hear our cry, O God. Heal our self-centeredness and indifference that makes us worry only when the virus threatens us. Open ways beyond timidity and fear that too easily ignore our neighbor. Hear our cry, O God. Strengthen and encourage those in public health services and in the medical profession, caregivers, nurses, attendants, doctors, all who commit themselves to caring for the sick and their families. Hear our cry, O God. Inspire, give insight and hope to all researchers focused on developing a vaccine. Hear our cry, O God. Sustain all workers and business owners who suffer loss of livelihood due to shutdowns, quarantines, closed borders, and other restrictions. Protect and guard all those who must travel. Hear our cry, O Lord. Guide the leaders of the nations that they speak the truth, halt the spread of misinformation, and act with justice so that all your family may know healing. Hear our cry, O God. Heal our world, heal our bodies, strengthen our hearts and our minds, and in the midst of turmoil, give us hope and peace. Hear our cry, O God. Hold in your gentle embrace all who have died and who will die this day. Comfort their loved ones in their despair. Hear our cry, O God. Let us remember all those who are in need of our care and our love in this time. And as we continue to go through this week, may the Lord continue to be with us, to guide us, and to protect us. We will call now on Reverend, who will give some notices. Just before we do that, our closing hymn. Our closing hymn, Will Your Anchor Hold, number 344 in the VIP.
my brothers and sisters, before the benediction, we have received this very important information from the Ministry of Health, a video that shows us how to put on the face masks, the proper way. So it is good that we share so that all of us will know, because sometimes you meet some people, they use the face masks as a style or something of the sort. But you see, the COVID has not gone yet, and therefore we need to continue to keep ourselves safe. So we are going to pray this video, just a short, just about 1 minute. So pay attention and listen to the video and watch it, and let's see. Yeah, so just watch it.
I am Dr. Gemma Sherry, and I am here to give some tips to help you with the proper use of your homemade mask. Face masks help reduce the spread of infectious diseases. When wearing a mask and using it as recommended, you are at less risk of contracting or spreading viruses. When wearing a mask, ensure that it is clean. Wearing a mask that has been washed reduces your chances of being exposed to infection. Wash or sanitize your hands before putting on your mask and before removing your mask, as well as after taking it off. Do not share your mask with others. Your mask should not be taken away from your face and given to others for their use. This contributes to possible spread of infections. Place your used cloth mask into a resealable bag if you do not plan to wash it right away. This prevents spreading any virus to other objects or surfaces. Wash cloth masks with soap and water and put to dry in sunlight, allowing it to dry thoroughly. Face masks should not be placed on young children under 2 years of age, anyone who has trouble breathing, or is unconscious or otherwise unable to remove the mask without assistance. So bear in mind that masks are effective in preventing viruses from spreading, but they are only one tool in preventing and controlling infections. So remember to daily practice the required hand hygiene, cough and sneeze etiquette, and physical distancing. These actions in combination make a big difference in reducing infections.
Thank you very much for watching this. Before we sing the doxology, let me say that we appreciate your participation in our online worship service. But as you know, this comes with a cost. And so we are trying to see how best we can improve all the time. So we want to appeal to all our viewers and listeners. Little contribution can help so that we can give you quality production. So I want to appeal those our members in overseas, members who are unable to come to worship. We appeal that you can call our church office if you have any donation to give, so that we can continue to give you very quality production. God will bless you. So let us try to do our best to at least contribute to this program, because it comes with a cost, the internet and the rest. So thank you very much, and God bless us all. Let us receive the benediction. Father, we thank you for the time that we have spent in your presence. We know your presence is everywhere, but it is always good that we come together to share fellowship with each other and give our worship to you. And we thank you for this time. We have not wasted time in your presence at all. The psalmist says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of God. Because in the house of God, there is freedom and liberty, O God. So as we depart from this house, we are not departing from your presence. We pray that, Lord, your presence will go with us. Throughout this week, we commit ourselves into your hands. Help us, O God, to be vigilant. Help us, O God, to be mindful that we will not allow ourselves for the devil to sow seed, bad seeds in our heart, but always the good seed that you have sown in our heart, we will exhibit those seeds. So bless our home, bless our workplaces, in our relationships. We thank you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his light of countenance upon you and give you peace. The name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Thank you very much. Let me seize the opportunity to thank our production team, Brother Prosper, Uncle Tim, Sister Mekodra for leading the service, Jamal, and Ibel. God bless us all. We appreciate your work. God bless.